Something smells sweet. Must be close to Honeydukes. Hogsmeade, here I come. Honeydukes. I can smell the chocolate.
Revelio.
I have the dried billywigs things. Now back to Gareth. I can only imagine how his new recipe is going to turn out.
Revelio.
Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade?
Levioso!
Revelio. Levioso. Accio. Revelio.
Troll in the village circle. You certainly made an impression.
Revelio.
You're worrying.
Come on in
far
and have a look around.
Nobody's looking at
no you. No touching, if you have sticky
Why
fingers.
Did you buy me a second pair? I hate these
Novelty
socks.
Novelty socks at that price can't be passed up. Be thankful you have
I'd
socks.
Rather have no socks than be dancing like this.
You're not dancing, you're exercising.
Father, why is he dancing?
See? And you'd said the charm's come out in the wash, but it hasn't.
Know. Someone so dramatic, just like your father. Anyone would think you had an affliction.
Has he been cursed?
Oh, please, can't we take these socks back to Mr. Hill and get me some
when
normal ones?
When you pay for your own socks, then you get to choose. Until then, you'll learn to be thrifty and behave. You're starting to cause a scene.
Papa, can we really wash charms out of things?
Don't be absurd. That woman will say anything to avoid spending a canut. If I haven't said it before, it's a pleasure doing business with you. I'd say that looks as if it was made for you. I'd say that looks as if it was made for you. I suspect you have a sharp eye for fashion. Be sure to stop by whenever you're about.
Thank you. I haven't heard any nasty comments lately.
I do get nervous when the owls fly into the room.
Hello, Gareth. I have those dried billywigs things.
You got them!
Incredible.
Happy to help. Here you go.
This is brilliant! Can't wait to get started.
Thank you again. I'll let you know when I've brewed my first batch of fizzing whiz beer.
What are you doing out here?
Challenging you to a game of Summoner's Court. I think it's time you faced a real opponent, outside of Ronan's little lesson in charms class. Summoner's Court isn't just a game. It's a battle of skill. A test of a witch or wizard's mettle. What say?
I'm in. Let's do it.
Brilliant! Summoner's Court. The ever-changing game. Akio.
All in the wrist. Akio.
Lucky shot. Akio. Nothing to it.
That was one for the ages.
Akio.
I'll let you have that one.
Well done. You beat me. Bit of good luck, that's all.
Come now, Leander. There's no need for that.
Fine, you're good. Better than I am, at least. I'll let the others know you're good enough to keep playing.
The others?
I lost 7 matches in a row to Samantha Dale. The others who play Summoner's Court thought that if you couldn't beat me, you wouldn't be enough of a challenge.
Chin up, Leander. Keep practicing and you'll get better.
I suppose you're right. I'll let the others know that your mettle's been tested and that you passed.
Sometimes it seems all roads lead to Hogsmeade.
Good of you to come. My friend, Professor Fig, speaks highly of you and your resourcefulness. He was vague as to details, but mentioned your having tracked down a difficult-to-find book. I wondered if you'd be willing to do a little detective work on my behalf.
Of course, Mr. Ollivander. Sounds most up my street.
Wonderful. You see, about a century ago, an heirloom applewood wand with a fairy wing core went missing from this very shop. My great-aunt suspected a student named Richard Jackdaw. He'd been serving as an assistant here and suddenly vanished.
Richard Jackdaw?
Like the bird. In fact, he was known to frequent the Hogwarts Owlry. We searched there, of course, but found no wand. We did find a series of statues similar to Jackdaw's. I'm certain they're a clue, but I cannot figure out where they lead. Jackdaw was last heard tittering about some pages with a map he'd stolen from Peeves. As you can imagine, the poltergeist was less than helpful.
Surely you could continue searching the Owlry.
Oh, one would think. However, the headmaster does not take kindly to an old wand maker loitering about the place. Can't say I blame him. Also, I have perhaps been looking for too long. I feel a fresh set of eyes and a bright mind like yours is sure to solve this riddle.
Is there anything special about the wand?
Oh, yes. It's terribly special. But not in the way you might think. It won't grant special powers to the caster, no. Nothing like that. But it will ease the hearts and minds of the Ollivanders to know of its return. And that power is immeasurable.
Why would the thief have taken the wand?
I must admit I have no idea. From what I can gather, he fancied himself an adventurer of sorts. Always looking for trouble. In fact, after he went missing, rumor had it his ghost was seen in Hogsmeade. Never heard much about him after that, but it seems as if his adventurous spirit may have got the better of him. Perhaps he thought that the wand had some special power simply because of its esteemed lineage. Astonishing how misunderstood the art of wand-making is.
I'll have a look for you. You've certainly given me plenty to go on.
Oh, you've brought hope to this old wand-maker's heart. Professor Fig was right. You are a remarkable student.
Hogsmeade, here I come.
in Merlin's name were you doing in the restricted section? What did you think you'd find there? Answers to your exams? If I discover even a trace of dark magic, I'll take you straight out of school, and that is a promise.
The statues Mr. Ollivander mentioned must be upstairs amongst the owls. Don't mind me, owls. I'm just here to help a friend. Now, where are those statues? I recognize those handles. The summoning charm should do the trick.
Accio!
Nothing. Here's a welcome surprise. Empty perches. Could be the right size for jackdaws. Or statues of jackdaws.
Levioso! Accio!
I'd best keep looking. Birds aren't afraid of heights. Perhaps I should look a bit higher. Nothing. No statues here.
Accio!
I'd best keep looking. Nothing. A map. It doesn't appear to be connected to the missing pages. Best hang on to it for now.
Accio! Levioso! Accio!
No statues here. This'll do nicely.
Levioso! Accio!
I'll take that, thank you. Here's a welcome surprise. I'd best keep looking. Nothing.
Accio!
This'll do nicely. What's happening?
Could it be? Has someone solved my puzzle after all these years? Well done indeed. Good news. If you've got something to hide, you found the perfect spot. Richard Jackdaw, at your service.
The Richard Jackdaw? So Mr. Ollivander was right. He wants his family wand back.
Goodness, I'd forgotten about that wand. I assure you, I don't have it on me. I'm almost certain I dropped it the moment I was beheaded in that cave. Oh, it was sheer folly to follow that map.
What map?
Ridiculous, really. Found it on some yellowed old pages Peeves had pilfered. Thought I could impress a girl. But that's a story for another day.
So, you stole a wand and then followed a map on some pages that you took from Peeves and followed that map to your doom.
Odd to hear it all reduced to such absurdity, but yes. Why do you care about some old wand?
I don't, really. Ollivander does. It's the pages I'm after. Might they be with the wand in the cave?
Indeed. Say, here's an idea. Why don't you meet me at the edge of the Forbidden Forest? I'd be happy to show you where to find them.
I think I can guess how you died, but who did it to you?
I was having a look about when I suddenly sensed a refreshing breeze, after which I felt, well, lightheaded. That's all I remember. Hence, if you do visit the cave, be prepared. I can't tell you what for specifically, but you seem a perceptive sort. Beware a light breeze.
Why would you steal Mr. Ollivander's family wand?
The family were always going on about how special it was, so I took it. Who could resist? Sadly, it wasn't special enough to save my neck. I fully intended to return it once I learned it was only special for sentimental reasons, but as you can see, I never got the chance.
How is it possible to steal from Peeves, a poltergeist?
I didn't steal the pages from his ghostly form. I merely found them in his wake of destruction. He's got a penchant for wrecking things. Books, bottles, suits of armor, whatever's likely to cause the most chaos. I doubt he even noticed they were gone.
If that's the only way for me to get those pages, I'll meet you there.
If you don't mind the sight of my decapitated skeleton, the wand and the pages are yours for the taking.
Revelio! Repairer. Lumos.
Lumos.
Revelio.
Relief to finally have an answer as to why that picture.
Duncan owes his reputation to you.
Take care of everything I had.
Professor, I completed all of your most recent assignments.
Well done. Then you're ready to learn Expelliarmus. Pay close attention. The disarming charm may often be all you need to defeat the most powerful dark witches and wizards you might encounter. Spellcasting requires a focused mind and a steady wand. Good work. The dummy is here if you wish to stay in practice.
Thank you.
Expelliarmus!
You seem to have the right question.
Accio!
Keep practicing. Expelliarmus may save your life one day.
Levioso! Expelliarmus!
Professor, do you have a moment?
I do. What is it?
I wondered, did you attend Hogwarts?
I did. I am a proud member of Ravenclaw House, like you. Why do you ask?
I was curious as to how Hogwarts has changed over the years.
I see. Well, the castle itself, as I'm sure you have surmised, is full of surprises. I dare say more than the staircases change around here. As for the students, well, they seem to get more capable every year. Although, we got up to just as much mischief in my day as you seem to now. I used to look the other way at all sorts of roguery when I was head girl. I can tell you, however, that I did once admonish a certain Phineas Nigellus Black for enjoying a sugar quill during a lecture.
I hadn't realized that you and Professor Black were, students here together.
Appearances can be deceiving. You see, I was once wounded by time itself.
Time itself? I never would have imagined such a thing.
Ah, well, it was the risk I took with my prior position. You may or may not have heard that I was an unspeakable at the Ministry for years.
An unspeakable? What does...
As you might suspect, I cannot speak about what we did. Suffice it to say, the job was not without its hazards. Now, I hope I've satisfied your curiosity for the moment.
You have. Thank you for speaking with me, Professor.
Keep up with your wand work. One must always be prepared for mischief, both inside and outside of the castle.
Expelliarmus!
Still at it, I see.
Accio! Levioso!
Nice to see you, my young friend.
Lumos.
Huh.
Accio.
Incendio!
You let Nora Treadwell get, didn't you? You're about to wish you hadn't.
I've seen you, Jewel. Your strategy won't work on me.
Jago! Leviosa! Incendio! 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 Accio!
Could it be a Merlin trial?
Levioso!
Revelio. Revelio. Protego.
Lumos. So tricky, after Lumos. Looks rather dark in there. Never stopped me before.
Lumos.
Incendio.
Revelio.
Incendio.
Revelio.
What are you up to now?
Here I am, as good as my word.
We meet again, Richard Jackdaw.
I suppose I shouldn't be surprised to see you. Only a Ravenclaw would travel this far in pursuit of knowledge.
Well said. Now where do we go from here?
Follow me. I shall lead you as far as I can, but I fear I may remain a tad reluctant to revisit the scene of my demise. Keep your eyes open for a birdbath. When you find it, say intramuros. I think it's Latin. Or Greek. As you can imagine, I never paid much attention in school. Shall we?
Aside from the birdbath, anything else I should look for?
Indeed. A few landmarks. A stone bridge, a waterfall, and, if I recall, a lake. You'll see.
You've been very helpful. Thank you.
Surprising how much of this is rather unfortunately coming back to me. Yes. You know, the closer we get, the more I'm remembering. Probably best I leave you to it.
Protego! Levioso! Accio! Levioso! Accio! The waterfall. For a thief, Jackdaw surprisingly as good as his word. Something oddly solemn about this place. Such regal creatures, stags. There it is, just as Jackdaw described. Thank you. intramuros.
Aren't you a little far from home?
Renrock knew you'd eventually lead us to whatever it is you're hiding.
Protego!
That was unimpressive!
Incendio!
You're not enough for me!
Accio!
Levioso!
This doesn't hurt!
Incendio! Incendio!
No!
I risk those loyalists will report back to Ranrock now. Let's see where Jackdaw has led me.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind. I wonder how big this place is.
Someone didn't want casual visitors down here. I wonder if any of the spells got me through this. Platform ought to be able to hold you there too. Accio! Help myself to this. Accio! Revelio! I'm glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind for me, but where could he be? Untouched chest. Jackdaw wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave. It's a good thing Jackdaw didn't fall down there. Well, help myself to this. Incendio!
Leviosa!
I thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loot, but there's no sign of him. An untouched chest. In his search of this cave. It is. The bridge, it's almost complete. Akio! Revelio. Accio. Richard Jackdaw left. Behind for me, but where could he be? Akio! More spiders. He's confident the hell out of the dragon. Potato! Stupid! That's odd. I'd have thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loop, but there's no sign of him. Need to look around for the symbol. Must be getting closer to Jackdaw's remains and those pages. We meet again, Richard Jackdaw. Oh, shame. Those splints. left of Ollivander's wand. At least I can take the pages. Here it is. The map that brought your doom, Jackdaw. Is there something beyond this room?
Leviosa! Accio! Leviosa! Accio!
Stego!
Stupid!
Accio!
Revelio.
I've seen this before. Gringotts and the restricted section. Where am I? Oh no, the room's starting to flood. How am I being protected? What sort of magic is this?
I can only hope this magic protects me until I'm able to make my way out of it.
What is this place?
Can it be?
It's you.
Has someone finally found our map chamber?
I recognize you from the Pensives. You're Professor Rackham.
I am indeed. I must confess that I am surprised to see someone so young standing before me.
I'm the same age that you and Isadora Morganarch were when you started at Hogwarts.
You've paid attention. And might I presume you share our ability
to see traces of ancient magic? Yes, sir, I do.
As you have likely realized by now, our ability gives us a unique relationship with all forms of magic. We can access expressions of magic that few others can. Opportunities will arise that allow you to sharpen this rare talent. Do not squander them.
I won't, Professor. Thank you.
We have much to discuss. But first, a map found in a certain book led you here. Place the book on the pedestal.
I don't have the book with me, sir.
That is unfortunate. I'm afraid we must pause our conversation until you return with the book.
I'm a bit confused, sir. Why is this room called the map chamber?
I assure you that all will be clear once the book has been placed on the pedestal.
The statues and carvings in the house on the cliffside, those are of you. Are you a seer?
I am.
Did you know that I would be here?
I cannot say more at present, except to say that your presence here does not entirely surprise me.
Very well. I'll retrieve the book right away.
Good. We shall speak again once the book is in place.
I found the pages and the map chamber. Why would I need the book?
Off on another adventure.
Revelio. Incendio.
I'm back at Hogwarts. I wonder when Professor Fig will be back. I did promise him I wouldn't neglect my studies while he was away. Suppose I have enough to distract myself with till he returns with the book.
You need to learn Depulso, the banishing charm, useful for pushing objects or adversaries away. Complete the required tasks and meet me in my classroom.
That's it.
Revelio. Revelio. Incendio. Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Everybody grab a broom, and we shall get started. Mr. Clopton, your attention, please.
Sorry, Madam Kagawa.
Everyone, please welcome a new student to our flying class.
Welcome.
Hello.
The goal of today is to remind all of you how to maneuver on a broomstick safely, as broom flight is, first and foremost, a means of transportation.
This, I fear, some of you have forgotten.
Diving, rolling, and loop-the-loops will not be taught or in fact tolerated in this class. We'll leave that to professional Quidditch players, like the Toyohashi Tengu.
Boo.
Not a fan, I take it?
Now, let's see how well everyone kept up with their practice over the summer holidays. For those who need a refresher, step up to your broom. Say up firmly and clearly. Then kick your leg over and rest your weight on the seat. Up!
Thank you.
Now, your turn.
Up!
Up!
Up, you stupid ratty school broom!
Up!
One leg over, so there's a leg on each side. None of that side saddle nonsense. A gust of wind will throw you right off. And if you hear my whistle while you're in flight, ground yourself at once. Good. Now, for your first lesson, fly through each ring in the courtyard. Do take care. The brooms are school property. I want them returned in one piece.
Wish I had my own broom. This is brilliant!
Well done. Now that you're acclimatized to your broom, let's see how well you manage with a more advanced exercise, shall we? This next set of rings will take you around the grounds for more of a challenge.
What a view!
Hello! Nice day for a flight!
Ha! Good. I've got this.
Ah, the old boathouse. Wish you could have experienced crossing the lake as a first year. Whoa! Our aquatic resident likes to make an appearance once in a while.
This is rather fun.
I say, I watched you fly through those rings. You seem to handle yourself on that dusty school broom well enough. I'd imagine you're ready for something a bit more challenging. But I'm getting ahead of myself. We met in the common room. I'm Everett Clopton. So, care to join me for a bit of high-flying fun?
Can't say no to that. What did you have in mind?
A bit of a detour, so to speak. Follow me. The tour is about to begin. Follow closely now. Right now, we're flying over the Transfiguration Courtyard. Lovely as ever. Let's hope the headmaster isn't having tea by the window today. Nice to get above it all, isn't it? Ahead of the garden. The Hufflepuff common room windows just peek out. Bit claustrophobic for my taste.
How is Everett flying so quickly?
Here's something handy to know. Lean forward for a burst of speed. Helpful if you need to escape a tricky situation.
Ha-ha! Now that's more like it.
You sure you're not part Hippogriff? There's the famous bridge. Think of all the magic holding it up. I mean, look at it. And Meowlery. That's a bit of solid architecture, isn't it?
Flying tips and a jaunt around Hogwarts. This is quite the tour, Everett.
That's Kagawa's whistle. This concludes our tour. Best hurry back. Better hurry and hand in our brooms. Dismount here.
And where have you two been?
Oh, hello, Professor. We were trying to get a bit of extra practice in.
Hefty points will be taken from each of you for not following my instructions. Mr. Clopton, I am disappointed in you. You're in this class because you're still not showing yourself, or frankly, your broom, the proper respect.
But, Professor...
Enough. Class is finished for the day. As for you, you do well to use better judgment in the future. Chin up. That was some rather good flying.
Sorry about that business with Kagawa, but you have to admit, those views were worth it.
It was worth losing a few house points for that detour.
You seem at home on a broom. Bet if you had a fancy model, you could fly laps around Imelda. She's Kagawa's favorite. I could show her a thing or two if I had my own broom. Hate having to return the school broom after class.
Perhaps I'll have to purchase a broom then.
If you can, you should. Wish I could. I recommend visiting Albie Weeks at Spintwitch's in Hogsmeade. He's always looking to test new models. I'll keep an eye out for you in the sky.
I do like
spit witches.
I wish I could afford my own broom. Instead of using my brother's hand-me-downs.
I've not forgotten about our library venture. How did you fare? If you're keen for some illicit spell practice, meet me outside the Defense Against the Dark Arts classroom. I know a discreet place near there.
Good day to you. I require assistance with a delivery and thought you might be interested. Please visit me at J. Pippin's Potions if you'd like to earn a few coins.
Please meet me in the 7th floor corridor as soon as you can. I have an idea for somewhere you can focus on your studies, away from prying eyes and distractions.
Italians and a historian's uniform.
I don't feel well.
Revelio.
Professor Weasley?
Somewhere away from prying eyes.
Forgive me, the headmaster stopped me and I... Merlin's beard! I see you've wasted no time. Well done. Shall we?
Off to you, Professor. What is this place?
This is the Room of Requirement. It only appears when one is in real need of it. Ordinarily, a student might stumble upon this room entirely by accident. If ever. I'd only planned to suggest to you how to find it by walking past that bit of wall, focusing on what you need. But you've managed to reveal the room on your own. While I'm here, we should take advantage of the moment. Now, where is Deke? He must have sneaked past and gone ahead.
Deke, Professor?
The house elf I was speaking to in my classroom your first day. Thought he might help you use the room once you've found it. There's no chance I'm clambering over this mess. This presents the perfect opportunity to teach you Evanesco, the vanishing spell. You can cast Evanesco to vanish certain objects, such as these chairs and other things here in the room. I suggest you practice the wand movements first, then you can clear the chairs away. Splendid. Now, cast Evanesco on the... Excellent work. You'll note that you are now in possession of Moonstone. We shall discuss its uses later. Let's move on. Where in Merlin's name is that elf? Is that... Goodness! My old school bag. I wondered where that had got to. Can't believe it's still here. I'll just take a quick look at this. Give you an opportunity to explore on your own until we locate Deke.
Yes, Professor.
Dear me. Can't you keep it down? Some of us are trying to rest.
Here.
here.
Levioso.
Accio.
This isn't as precarious as it looks.
Revelio!
No, not... That's not helpful, you worthless pile of tin!
How does anyone other than a house elf manage to get around in here?
Revelio!
What was that? Was that a golden snitch?
Perhaps you should summon your wits and find out.
Accio. Revelio. Accio. Levioso.
Levioso.
Accio. Accio.
Levioso.
Accio.
hope that house elf can find us in here.
Yikes! Careful!
Huh?
Oh, there you are! Wait right there. Deke will come to you. Hello.
Ah, Deke. We've been looking for you.
Apologies, Professor Weasley. Deke was looking through some of what's appeared in the room since Deke was last here. Is this the student?
Indeed it is.
Deke is honored to meet you.
Deke has been a friend since I was a second year. We discovered this room together. I mentioned you to Deke. We believe that you might be able to benefit from this room like I did. Deke, would you be so kind?
Of course, Professor Weasley. The Room of Requirement will always be equipped for the Seeker's needs. It's unplottable, so won't appear on any map. Most happen upon it by accident, if ever. Deke's seen students in need of an extra file for potions stumble upon the room filled with them. You seem to have accessed it in its form as the Room of Hidden Things.
I was thinking about needing a place away from prying eyes. Brilliant.
Oh, that explains it then.
What I need specifically is a place where I can catch up on my schoolwork without distraction.
Well then, the room can provide you with precisely that. Now, it's time to focus on what you need. Just close your eyes. Imagine the room precisely as you need it. The room will do the rest.
Yourself quite a canvas to work with. I look forward to seeing what you do with the space. Ah, and it seems the room has provided you with a desk of description. Excellent. It can identify unfamiliar items of clothing. One should always understand the effects of anything in which one is clothed. You'll find plenty of items of clothing that need to be identified. The desk will be an invaluable resource.
I imagine the desk of description will come in handy.
It will. I hope you'll take advantage of it. Now, I'll give you a brief lesson in conjuring. The room might not provide everything you need on its own.
Conjuring?
Yes, the magic of creating or conjuring objects. I'll teach you. Very good. When conjuring more complex objects, you'll need what's called a spellcraft. Spellcrafts are like recipes. They list the ingredients or resources needed to conjure a particular object. You should have acquired some for a potion station and potting table from tomes and scrolls in Hogsmeade.
I did. Where can I find the resources I need?
While resources such as moonstone can be obtained throughout the Highlands, it's much safer and easier to purchase them. They can also be collected by vanishing objects in the room, such as the chairs you vanished earlier. In fact, you should have enough resources for now.
I see. Can I regain resources by vanishing something I've already conjured?
You can indeed. Quite perceptive. Why don't you give it a try? Go ahead and conjure the potion station and potting table. You should find both familiar since they'll resemble the ones you've already used to study magical plants and brew potions in class. Well done. You can use these whenever you need to brew potions or grow plants. Presuming, of course, you've collected any seeds or potion ingredients you need in Hogsmeade or outside the castle grounds. Deke will be here to answer any questions you may have. Do not underestimate his insights.
Can you tell me a bit more about Deke?
He's been at Hogwarts longer than I have, and seems to know its every nook, cranny, and secret. We discovered this room together when I was a student. Deke has had a good deal of experience, both here at Hogwarts and at a previous post. I shall let Deke tell you more when he's ready. But again, you would be wise to listen to any suggestions he may have.
Can I use this type of transfiguration magic outside of the room?
Conjuring and vanishing are strictly forbidden elsewhere in the castle. We've charms in place to enforce that. It would be exhausting to reverse the errors in both judgment and magic. But the Room of Requirement has its own rules.
I will be sure to speak with Deke if I need anything. Thank you.
Good luck. I shall linger a bit longer in case you'd like to learn another transfiguration spell for use in the room.
Thank you.
Transfiguration, if you have a moment.
I'm ready for the next lesson, Professor.
Very well. First, you'll need to gather some moonstone. You can acquire it by vanishing items here in the Room of Requirement, or you can gather it carefully outside of the Hogwarts grounds. Return to me once you've gathered enough, and we shall begin the lesson.
I have the moonstone you requested, Professor.
Good. Then we may begin your lesson. You can conjure more than potions and herbology tables. Conjuration can be used to decorate this space to your liking. Why don't you try it on the walls and floor? Good work.
I've conjured everything I can. What's next, Professor?
I think you're ready to take on alteration. The altering spell will allow you to customize any conjured item. You can change the colours, patterns, and styles of your furniture to suit your taste. Let's get started, shall we? Watch closely as I demonstrate how to perform the altering spell. Just aim your wand. Conjured item and perform the altering spell to customize.
nothing to identify, for now at least.
I have some questions about alteration, Professor.
Yes?
How do I use the altering spell?
Simply aim your wand at a conjured item that you would like to customize, and you can change an item's appearance in a number of ways. You've been practicing.
Thank you. Thank you.
I have some questions about alteration, Professor.
Yes?
Protego!
On the room's architecture. Try these new designs on the floor or balcony. Your space might benefit from a bit of ambiance, don't you think? Deke, would you mind?
Of course, Professor Weasley. Professor Weasley showed Deke this bit of magic some years ago.
Professor Weasley said I should ask you about changing the room's ambience?
Of course!
I would like the room to feel as if it's being lit by the moon.
Oh, sounds perfect.
Quite a difference. Of course, you needn't keep this style if you don't like it. You can always ask Deke to change it back. Now you have learnt a good bit about alteration.
Thank you, Professor. The room is full of possibilities.
Indeed. No matter how much time I spend here, the room always manages to surprise me. Equips itself to your needs. It must have sensed that you needed more space to practice spellcasting. If you'd like to customize the space further, you can use these spellcrafts. You'll find more of them both inside and outside the school.
Thank you, Professor. I shall keep an eye out.
Good. I'll leave you to it. This is your space now. Use it wisely.
Wonderful.
I'd like to ask you about changing the room's ambience.
Of course. What sort of overall look most appeals to you?
I'd like the room to feel natural and earthy, as though I'm outdoors.
Oh, sounds perfect.
Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade?
Ah, new face. Wonderful.
Hello. Mr. Weeks, is it?
Albie Weeks at your service. Welcome to Spint Witches. Apologies if you came by before and weren't able to come in. Shop's been closed since trade routes were disrupted. Had to travel as far as London to meet with my supplier. And I've only just returned, thankfully with inventory. I presume you're in the market for a new broom? Got a few rare yew weavers available. Ember Dash, Silver Arrows. Wind Wisps too. No matter what broom you choose, you'll be pleased. They're all exceptional, both in quality and performance.
You said disrupted trade routes caused you to close, Spint Witches.
Terrible it's been. Trade routes reported as unusable. Evidently criminals were overtaking roads, threatening hamlets. I can fly safely almost anywhere, but you try flying with an inventory of brooms on your back. No easy feat. Right then, back to work. If a particular broom takes your fancy, just let me know.
Do you mind sharing more about your brooms?
I've a passion for them. Every detail of every model. Take Wind Wisps, well known for their quality ash handles. Yew weavers are rare because some fear flying them, likely to do with the Yew Wand's darker reputation. Then you add the Ember Dash, known for its handsome appearance. Working with brooms every day makes me practically giddy. It's one of many reasons I cherish running this shop.
Sounds quite the array of brooms. I'll have a look around. Thank you.
What are we looking for today? That item is of the highest quality. That item is of the highest quality. You'll be thrilled with that broom, I promise you. Nice doing business with you. Thanks for stopping by. Whilst nearly any broom will certainly be a step up from the practice brooms in Kagawa's class, they all have their limitations. You seem to be a flyer who might be interested in, say, some enhancements.
Go on.
Ha! Knew I was right about you. I think you'll be quite happy with the performance of any broom at lower altitudes. But you may notice that speed consistency tends to falter as you rise. I believe I can remedy this issue. I have some ideas for enchantments, upgrades, if you will, that will improve the performance of any broom you fly. What I need is someone to conduct a broom flight and report back to me so I can perfect the upgrades. As it happens, another Hogwarts student, Imelda Reyes, is using abandoned broom courses for time trials. Clever girl. An ideal situation for collecting flight statistics. If you were to compete for the best time and succeed, then report back to me with how your broom behaved, I could complete work on my first upgrade. What say?
That sounds intriguing. I'll see what I can do.
Thank you. It'll be worth your while. If I'm right, the new upgrade ought to enhance brooms in every regard. And I can give you a special price. The time trial should be a bit of fun too. Go to the Quidditch pitch and Imelda Reyes will sort you out. Once you've beaten Imelda's time, be sure to let me know.
I can't help but admire Mr. Weeks's enthusiasm.
Revelio.
Sometimes it seems all roads lead to Hogsmeade. Revelio.
Ravenclaw. eye. Look like you've seen a ghost.
If only.
What do you have in store for me this time?
Accio! Levioso! Accio! Levioso!
Incendio!
Expelliarmus!
Accio!
Revelio!
Incendio! Lumos.
Levioso.
Accio.
Revelio.
Lumos.
Incendio. Revelio.